Hi, my name is Jonathan, and today we are going to be reviewing the AUNA Real 525 surround sound system. This system is a 5.1, which means we get five of these satellites, including this big one, and we get an internally housed subwoofer system as well. The system works on 125 watts, so we're dealing with some power here. The sound quality is pretty good too. We're going to get into that. But before we do, let's cue the intro. Okay, I'm going to be honest. We don't have an intro yet. So we'll get into it right now. So to start off with the review, we have two color selections that this is available in. The first one's black, and this sells for $99.99. It's also available in a walnut finish with a black face. That is $89.99 at the time of this making of this video. I'm going to put a link down in the description to that. Now, I am an affiliate to this product, so if you click that link, I can earn money on whatever purchases you make at that link. So it's a very nice system. As you can see, we have 11 speakers, actually 8. We're going to get into that as I break it down. And we got this 5-inch subwoofer here. Now, the power is pretty decent. You're going to get some loud sound out of this thing. It's 125 watts in total. So we're dealing with some power here, nothing crazy, but you're going to hear it, and your neighbors might be angry at you, especially for this price point. You can't really argue with that. This also works on Bluetooth, USB, it's got RCA cables for your TV, and it's also got a DVD surround sound hooked up. So if you wanted to hook up your center and your front and right and your rear and your subwoofer, then it's almost as though the movie surrounds you, which is an awesome feature for this system here. The sound quality is really good. It's loud, it's prevalent. If you're into the R&B rap kind of scene like I am, when you have it cranked, the subwoofer can't exactly hang with the beat, but it's a little small compared to what it looks. We're gonna get into the deeper parts of this as I break it down, but they're not the most honest when they create this design, as you can see these little speakers up here. Only two of them are actual speakers on the shorter ends, the front ones. They're real, or they're fake on the front ones, but on the back ones, they're fake for the tweeters. But the big ones are real. It's also fake for this little one right here. And the subwoofer looks pretty big. As you can see here, it's a pretty decent size, but once I pull this grate off here, it's not as big as it looks, but the output of the system in general, you're gonna appreciate. It's not too bad. For some of the cons we have here, the baby 5-inch subwoofer can't exactly hang. With a 125-watt system, we're putting 15 to each satellite, and then 50 to this subwoofer. And 50 to a 5-inch subwoofer, it's not exactly the best. And for a cheap home system like this, it's what you can expect. There's three fake speakers, as I mentioned before, with the close range and this center right here. They're not real, and I'm gonna show you those here in a little bit. The RCA cables that these hook up to this big system here from, they're a little short. The front ones are 5 feet. And the rear ones are 12, I believe. Yeah, 12 feet. I'm also going to link to some RCA cables in the bottom there in case you want to get some extensions, you know, actually surround your living room. I have a pretty large living room. New TVs, there's another issue I'm going to give you. New TVs don't use the double RCA hookups anymore. They use a single port. So you're going to have issues there. My 65-inch Roku comes with an adapter. Have I gotten that adapter to work? I have not. No matter what I've tried, I can't get it to. But the Bluetooth, still great to use. There's a USB there. It takes a memory card. You must be a pretty intricate person to use a memory card for your surround sound. But if you want to do it, AUNA is ready for you. And the last con that I have on this list would be that this gets hot. Now, if you leave this on all the time, I'm sure the amp runs consistently, so it's ready. And I've had this system for 2 years, and when you leave it on, it gets really hot. I've left it on for 6 months at a time. So I'm not saying there's a fire hazard. I have not burnt to death in my sleep yet, but the system definitely gets hot. So now that we've gone over the pros and cons, which you can find a more detailed list of the pros and cons in the link to my blog post down below. I'll put that in there. Now let's break it down, listen to some sound quality on here, take a look at the speakers. I'm going to take the faces off so you can see what we're actually dealing with. So the sound quality in these things, not too bad. Now we can listen. The cool thing about this is it's got a detailed remote, so you can change the subwoofer volumes and the speakers individually, their volume. So if I want to turn up the front right speaker, it's already all the way up. I keep them all the way up. That's just how I set my audio system. Except the subwoofer, I keep that at zero, unless I'm bumping to some R&B, then I gotta turn it all the way down. Just, I like it loud. But it actually gets quite loud. That's only halfway up. It's loud, and the sound qualities are crisp. Now, I've seen some people complain about the highs. I don't believe it, you know. As you can hear, Katy Perry is currently going to town on this system. So I'm not too worried about that. But the fact that we can change the center to low, so if you want to set it in different areas, different parts of your house, however you were to want to do it, it's all adjustable here. Now we're going to get into the breakdown. So I'm going to pause this video, set it up over here, so you guys can actually see what's going on inside these speakers, and take a look at this subwoofer we got over here. Okay, so now we're back. I've got these taken apart here. I have a correction to make, actually. The rear speakers are fake. The rear behind you use fake tweeters. You see, I can pull this out. That's not a real tweeter. It doesn't hook up to power. There's nothing in there. It's plastic. So they make it look like you got a speaker there. You don't. And that's the same in the other long range. And you also get a fake one in this center one here. But this is real. So that's where the sound comes from. And there's no complaints on the sound quality. From me, at least. So there's that. I saw in the video this actually looks pretty decent sized. It's not bad. It's honestly quite large, but for a subwoofer, I think of some 12s that I'd put in my car. You know, I'm a fan of bass, so I like some deep bass. So this thing will put out some bass for you. You will hear it predominantly in your music, but in terms of actually like turning that up and getting this stuff to start wobbling off your table, I don't think you're gonna see it. So overall, it's got a switch back here to turn it on. Off. My Bluetooth probably came disconnected from me doing that. It's actually got buttons here. You can get your input. I guess I have to turn it on first. Where is the on? Oh, it's right there. So I turn it on there. It's the top button. And then I can hit my input. Oh, it's on the Bluetooth already. Man, I just switched it. So then it goes DVD, aux, which I have not identified an aux port on here yet. It indeed has one. It also has an FM antenna if you want to buy one of those. You can listen to the radio. You can catch your church programs, local broadcast. So there's many options if you're into that kind of stuff. Aux, FM. I don't have a speaker hooked up or an antenna hooked up, so it's not going to work. The USB. And we got Bluetooth. That's what I always stick on. Bluetooth is just so much easier. And that's gonna blink. I come over here. My settings. And then I can just connect to that. Slowly but surely. Usually connects instantly. With your phone, it's really nice because it'll connect automatically when you walk in the room. Doing my laptops can be kind of a pain in the butt. But I'm not too worried about that. Now you can go into your phone. I don't have my phone here. Overall, gonna say, for the money, I couldn't ask for any more. I'd give it an 8.5 out of 10, just to be fair. If you want to compare this to a $400, $500 surround sound system that you're going to get from Bose, it's not going to hold up. These speakers just aren't large enough for it. You know, you'd get some big ones with something like that. But in terms of $99, $89.99, you get both those. The lowest prices are in my bio down there in the description of this video. It's a link to the lowest prices available on these. Now we connect to the Bluetooth. You just don't see prices that low for 8 speakers. Makes it look like 11. Your friends aren't gonna know they're fake. Look at you, balling out for $99.99. You can't go wrong. So I would overall say to buy it. You know, you compare it to other stuff. Wouldn't say to buy it, but if you're in the market for a surround sound system, you know where to go. I haven't reviewed any of the other ones. I haven't bought any of the other ones yet. Maybe someday in the future, I hope to keep making these videos. If you like this video, if you learned something, go ahead and like, maybe subscribe. I don't know. If you want, doesn't hurt you, doesn't cost a dime. You can continue supporting me to make this content. I plan to cover an array of products. Services, I can offer business advice. This isn't the only thing I'm doing. I'm just doing this so I can provide value. If you have something you'd like to see me do on here, set it in the description. I try to be funny, not always a thing. But either way, you'll get to see me on here. And I've got good taste in music, so yeah, the music doesn't want to play. I was hoping. Bottles in the ice, like a blizzard. When we drink, we do it right. Getting slizzard, sipping scissor. Am I right? Like 3-6. So I hope you guys have a good day, and I hope you enjoyed this video that I made for you. See you next time.